is revised. Preached this word before. I believe today this body needs this word. We need encouraged, amen? Every one of us need encouraged in the Lord. I'm not going to be your cheerleader today, but I'm definitely here to try to pump you up. Amen? All right. Let me see. Chapter 19. Read a good bit of scripture today. We're going to read it quick. I'm going to try to minister quick. I'm going to try to teach quick. But at the end, I'm going to preach hard. Amen?
Amen.
All right, honey, if you will be my reader for today, which you probably always are. Luke 19 and 29, I want you to read all the way to 33, okay?
As they came to the towns of Bethphage and Bethany, on the Mount of Olives, he sent two disciples ahead. Go into that village over there, he told them, and as you enter it, you will see a colt tied there that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you what you're doing, just say, the Lord needs it.
Okay, excuse me. Okay, first of all, he's telling these disciples to go to someone else's property and take a colt. Now, Brother Sean, if you didn't know me, you didn't know Brother Chris, and you didn't know Brother Greg, you're out there baling hay, we come walking up on your property, going to take something of yours, you would have to be in the right frame of mind with God. You would have to be a holy man of God for us to be able to come up in there and say, Jesus needs this colt. And I want to add that this colt has never been ridden. Okay, so anybody that knows anything about horses or donkeys or anything, they need broken in, am I correct? Or they're just crazy. They will get crazy with you if you get trying to go for a ride. But what's so awesome about this scripture is these guys go and get this colt, and Jesus rides this colt with no problem at all. Why? Because he's Christ.
That's right.
And even the animals recognize
that
he's
right.
God.
Right.
And there are so many people in this world that don't. Doesn't it drive you nuts? An animal. As dumb as an animal you would think would be, dumber than you or I, you would think that every human being would know about Jesus or serving. But see, this colt even bowed to our Christ and was willing and acceptable to be used by Christ. Amen? All right, I just want to put it. It will cost you.
So they went and found the colt just as Jesus had said, and sure enough, as they were untying it, the owners asked them, why are you untying our colt? The disciples simply replied, the Lord needs it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their garments over it for him to ride on.
All right, continue.
Then the crowd spread out their coats on the road ahead of Jesus. As they reached the place where the road started down from the Mount of Olives, all of his followers began to shout and sing as they walked along, praising God for all the wonderful miracles they had seen. Bless the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest.
Okay, now as he was riding this colt into the city, a multitude of people that loves him was laying down their palm branches and even their clothes before him, honoring him as the king. But he was humble enough to ride in on a colt instead of this great big fancy horse, best you could buy. It was a form of humility of our Christ riding on a colt.
But some of the Pharisees. Excuse me. Oh, I'm sorry.
But 38, the things that they were saying is what we need to say every day of our life. If we can't get used to it down here, there's going to be a lot of it when we make it to heaven, if we make it to heaven. That's the key word right there, if. But in 38, they, the people, the multitude, was saying, "Blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord." Now they was chanting this. Yes. They was praising him. Okay? Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. And they said it over and over and over. And guess whose nerves that they was getting on? That's
my Lord. Some of the Pharisees among the crowd said, "Teacher, rebuke your followers for saying things like that." Jesus said, "If they keep quiet, the stones along the road will burst into cheers and praise."
Stop. Okay. Sister Lacey, when you are praising God, don't allow, and I'm not saying you would or you would or anybody else would that's in your circle of friends, but don't you allow anybody to try to shut you up.
Amen. Amen.
Because, see, the Pharisees did not agree with Jesus Christ. They didn't like him. He was a troublemaker in their eyes. He was a man of God. He did everything by the book. They couldn't. They were sinners. And they couldn't stand the very fact that he could and they couldn't. That he was holy and they wasn't. Okay? So they hated him. Alright? They wanted to shut the multitude up. They wanted Jesus Christ to say, and rebuke means to shut you up. They wanted him to rebuke the multitude to shut them up because they was on the nerves of that. You understand what's going on, what's going down here? But Jesus looked at him and said, "Listen," because he knew who he is and who he was. He knew that if he would have rebuked the multitude that was praising his name and singing to him praises, that the very rocks in the hillside would cry out with blessings upon him. So no matter what, there's nothing going to be stopped as far as something's going to praise our God.
Amen.
So what I'm telling you, Lacey, is don't let the rocks take your place. You praise him.
Yes, we got
you praise him with all your might, with all your strength, with all of you, each and everyone in this place. You know where I'm going. If you have notes, if you have a pen, I want you to write down "no rock." Because it's time. It's time to get up.
Yes.
It's time to praise your God. Because if you don't, somebody else is going to take your place.
Come on.
And God forbid it will be a rock.
Yes.
Come on. Come on. I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet. Let's go to Judges. Judges 15. First scripture. It's the seventh book in the Bible from the beginning. Everybody there say amen. Judges 15. Oh, Judges, yeah. Chapter 15, verse 1. All right, honey.
Later on during the wheat harvest, Samson took a young goat as a present to his wife. He intended to sleep with her, but her father wouldn't let him in.
Honey, could I get you to read from the King James, please?
But it came to pass within a while after, in the time of wheat harvest, that Samson visited his wife with a kid, the goat, and he said, "I will go in to my wife into the chamber," but her father would not suffer him to go in.
Would not let him go in. Why? Because she was not there. Go ahead.
And her father said, "I verily thought that thou hast utterly hated her. Therefore I gave her to thy companion. Is not her younger sister fairer than she? take her up, Brady.